Hey, I am Yale, and I love giant robots. I've always wanted to control my very own Megazord and wreak havoc on a non-suspecting city. So, instead of dreaming about it, why don't I make one myself? Alright, so I want to control a giant robot. But I want to do it in a very intuitive way, like the Jaegers in Pacific Rim or the AMP suits from Avatar. I need a way to track my arms very precisely, so I can choose to hit the stoplight instead of the old lady. There are all these cool technologies that do full body tracking with fancy machine learning or depth sensors, but I don't have anything like that laying around. What I do have is the most revolutionary console of our lifetime, the Wii. Yes, the Wii. I remember spending countless hours swinging those Wiimotes around. It's so intuitive. Even your grandma understands how to use it. But I need my exact pose, not just some random swing to play my game. I want to be able to do the chicken dance. And when I only know where my hands are, that won't work. But fear not, the Wiimotes can be used for much more than just swinging. They have this extension called Wiimotion Plus, which has a gyroscope inside. Gyroscopes can keep track of its rotation by spinning really fast, like how it's much easier to stay upright when you're biking quickly compared when you're standing still. What if I 3D printed the grip to strap Wiimotes to my arms, track their rotation, and then match those rotations in the game to replicate my pose exactly? Oh Yale, what a good idea. Yeah, I know, I'm a genius. Alright, so that covers the arms, but that's only half of the story. I mean, I got these two other gangly limbs just hanging around. And what's more fun than stomping around? Because connecting 8 Wiimotes at once can be quite the hassle. I mean, I was a Wii fanboy, but 8 Wiimotes is just pushing it. Even for me. After digging around and testing my old peripherals, I remembered I have the perfect thing just laying around. A giant balance board. That's just perfect. It's like Nintendo designed this device to control with your feet. Just imagine me leaning back and forth and stomping all over the place. However, there was one giant problem. I don't want to play the game on my Wii. It only outputs in 480p. We real gamers know that the only way to play a game is at 1080p 60 at minimum. I need a way to connect my Wiimote to my computer to utilize the raw power of my machine. Luckily, I'm not the only one who wanted to do that. Since Wiimotes use regular Bluetooth to connect to the Wii, I can just as easily connect them to my computer. The real challenge lies in interpreting the data from the remotes. There is already a great GitHub repository that has a Unity framework, which is just plug and play. You just find your Wiimote and ta-da! I can get all the buttons I need. I can also send data to the Wiimotes, like lighting up the player LEDs. And of course, the most important part, the Wiimotion Plus data. I can already see myself controlling a giant robot. But not everything was plug and play. There were some essential features missing that I desperately needed. Like support for the Wii balance board and the nunchuck pass-through. Not that I'm complaining, of course. It's the perfect time to finally become a valuable member of society and contribute to an open source repository. The Bluetooth communication is very efficient. It sends just 8 bytes of data that contains all the information. Now, what byte is used for what information? Luckily, all of that has already been figured out by the WeeBrew community, so all I had to do was translate the tables into a usable interpreter. But let me tell you, this was one hell of an experience. For some reason, Nintendo decided to make different types of Wiimotes throughout their lifetime, and they all have different protocols that need to be followed, as some of the Wiimotes don't listen to the commands, but eventually I got it working. The balance board has 4 pressure sensors in each corner, so I can track where I'm leaning by checking which side detects more pressure. Woo! Look at me leaning. What a revolutionary way of controlling things. Okay, now that I got a way to get all the data from the Wiimotes, it's time to start making the actual controller for my giant robot. I divided my body up in 3 parts. The torso, the arms, and the lower body. The arms are the most important part, so they have to feel just right. I only get the rotations from the Wiimote, but luckily, I have an elbow that makes sure my lower arm sticks to my upper arm. So the rotation is all I need to get the exact pose of my arm. Because I wanted to destroy stuff, I needed a way to collide with other objects in a realistic way. I can't just use the rotation of the controllers to set my arms to, because that way they would just go through everything and I would be like a ghost trying so desperately to get some interaction with the real world. But luckily, this isn't my first rodeo. I can use configurable joints to set a target position and rotation to my joints. Give them some colliders, and ta-da! Pushing stuff around has never been so fun. Next were the legs. Contrary to the arms, I didn't have the exact rotation of my bones at every moment. So I had to use IK. Sometimes it just is what it is. Oh well, IK works great for legs. I programmed a simple IK system for the feet, with a pull for the knees to get him to do some crazy dance moves. I set up the balance board data collector to send me a center of mass. At that point, I can determine where I was leaning. And even better, once my foot would leave the board, my weight would shift so far to the side that I could use that data to tell the game to lift the robot foot as well. That's great, but now I'm just marching in place. The buildings aren't going to come to me, I need to move. Luckily, there was still one direction that I hadn't used, the forwards and backwards. I made the foot goal follow the leaning direction, so if I were to lean forwards, the foot that is lifted would follow it. And when I plop back down, the foot would be placed straight down. And so, the robot has moved forwards. Then I just do the same thing, and on and on and on and on we go. To turn the whole body, I can't just turn my body, because then I would just step off the balance board. So I had to use the joystick. I know, it's not that special, but hey, if I'm gonna be holding a nunchuck, I might as well use it, you know? Okay, the robot is now fully controllable, but it looks kinda, well, it's just a bunch of blocks. Time to make the actual robot. Since the arms were so important, I made them giant destruction devices. And the legs, well, you need legs, but that's not the main attraction here, so they can be just teeny tiny toddler legs. And of course, I need stylish sunglasses to match mine. After I linked the right parts to the controller, I am now a robot. Wait a second, where is the stuff to break? Right now I feel like a mixer without dough, or a lawnmower without grass. Time to make an environment. I started with modeling some buildings. Hold on, what are you doing? We're not going to make each building one by one. We are lazy. I mean, we are a special kind of lazy that prefers to spend hours creating a procedural tool to do some simple repetitive task that would take way less time. Alright, I guess I'll make a procedural city generator. First thing, the buildings. Buildings are just simple blocks for the most part, but it's important to get the textures to line up right to get proper levels. I mapped the building face UVs to stretch a little bit to always be a whole number of tiles. That way the building doesn't have any half floors on top. I also made some variations in the texture to make more distinct buildings. Of course, they can be whatever dimension I want. That's procedural for you, baby. Alright, alright, that's looking good. But the buildings still lack a very important feature. Nothing happens when you hit them. I got the slicing algorithm from this GitHub repo, and after some small adjustments, it worked great. I just hit the building with the thing, and boom, it breaks down. Of course, I don't want a single building, I want a whole city. I made another script to spawn the buildings in a grid, and made a whole bunch of things controllable, so I can make it whatever size I want. I also varied the height of the buildings with a smooth noise function to get a nice and random skyline. And I also added some falloff to mimic the real city, with the very high buildings in the center and the much lower ones at the edges. To make the ends of the city less jarring, I also added a pier and a giant water plane with the basic water shader made from a Brachis tutorial, rest in peace. Alright, now that I have the robot and the city, it's time to destroy some stuff. Give me those delicious points. Yes, yes, give them to me. Pow, pow, yeah. However, this was not the end goal. There was still one more thing coming. To beat my final foe, I needed to be really emerged. And what better way to be that than with some super cool armor? Yes, yes, like that. Let's get this monster. Alright, ladies and gentlemen. Jelle is preparing for battle. Oh, that's not very smooth. Well, it's a warm-up for a reason. Jelle is approaching the monster. At his own pace. Almost there. Alright, the battle can begin. Wow, he's so close to the edge. Just a little push. Alright, monster. Show me what you got. Get off me. Headbutt. That'll show him. One more hit. Boom. Yes, he's down. But our work here isn't done. This city is in desperate need of a janitor. And another one. And another one. Now, let's get this monster off the island. Yeah. There he goes. No more monster in this city. Jelle has single-handedly leveled this city. Well, with a little help of the robot, of course. Well, you know what they say. The clothes make the man. Thanks for watching, everybody. Click that like button if you want me to make more cool stuff. And subscribe if you want to see when I make cool stuff. See you guys next time, where I'll do something in my room. Wow.